So those of you who have not gotten, for the sake of time, sign on to Flourish Africa. She will be directly engaged in addressing the issues. Some of the issues that came in are quite personal, and I don't think we have all the time to address them. She's addressed some of it, because a lot of it goes down to the self-esteem when people feel hopeless. She's going to address that. We also have the marketplace, where you can find a lot of her materials in the marketplace. And then I just want to end with one question, one two-part question in the few remaining minutes. It's a question: as a successful leading female entrepreneur, how did you ensure that your voice was heard in the boardroom and you were not just seen as a pretty face? And then the second part of the question is, how do you reconcile the narcissism of success? Because people can be kind of, you know, they can be kind of negative towards successful people, and the empathy of God. So the first one, how did you make sure that men in general or in that boardroom, they can just see you as a pretty face?
Well, you have to prove yourself.
Yes.
You have to prove that you're able. And how do you prove that you're able? You have to make sure that you prepare. You prepare yourself. Things that you do not know, you're going to find out about. If you need to find mentors, by all means do that. If you need to go online, by all means do that. If you need to go for training sessions, yes, I made sure that I went for trainings in different parts of the world to improve myself, to ensure that I would know what I'm saying. And in some cases, I let my children teach me. Yes. I went knocking on doors to get answers, to know what I'm talking about, so that I could flow in technical meetings. And people would normally tend, especially men, would normally tend to think that, yes, you are just a pretty face. What could there be to you? They forget that God created both men and women with brains. The Bible did not tell us. The Bible did not tell us that God took part of Adam's brains, and Adam was left with three quarters, and a quarter was given to Eve. No. He gave Adam brains, and he gave Eve brains. In fact, God was even partial to the woman. We have a lot of virtues to assist the men folk, and we use it to give them the support that they need. Without the neck, the head cannot stand. They need us. So we arm ourselves by preparing ourselves, by being all-rounders, to be able to be round pegs in round holes.
There's nothing wrong with beauty and brains, so don't feel if they think you're just a pretty face. But let me just close this out and say that some of these questions that we've received for Mrs. Alakisha are exceptional questions, but for the sake of time, we won't have time to address them. But this is just a part of a broader movement, and so we're going to be a part of Flourish Africa. Give our commitment on that, and thank you for even extending your generosity, your philanthropy, and your heart even further than you have. And we will take up some of these questions in the matters of the heart in the young women's ministry, because I think they're very important. Thank you all very much. This is Alakisha. Thank you.
Thank you very much for having me.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure to be with you.
Okay, let's show her how much we love and appreciate.
opportunity to eavesdrop on a conversation between two members of business as we just had. You do take it. Once again, please give it up for Lady Rosa and Mrs. Coloroso and the teacher.
You can find the books and get more answers. Thank you so much.